Hello, everybody. Welcome. Spectrum, Gateway Dance Theater's Showcase of the Arts. It's a microcosm of the arts and sciences, and that's who we are. We are entering our 50th anniversary next year, and we need you badly. We need you to sustain us. We need you to join us. We need you to participate, and we need you to spread the word so we can go on for the next 50 years to be accessible to everyone, including you. So thank you for coming, and namaste.
My name is Amy Putney Koenig. I have a studio in Des Moines, Iowa. I make paintings, drawings, and collage pieces. I love to paint great big murals out in the community to inspire, to kind of change the way we look at the world around us with bright color and symbolism and messaging to remind you that you're amazing, that we're more than what we're looking at all around us. I like the idea of elevating community with artwork and bringing some sort of joy and love and humor with my paintings and murals. I also create posters and illustrations. I feel like I've been an artist all my life, and a lot of my art to me looks like the art I was making when I was a kid. So it's I'm really grateful to be able to continue to be an artist. I went to Iowa State University. I got a degree in fine arts and visual studies, and my emphasis was computer art and fiber art and painting. So I have been an art director and a designer for Styx Object Art and Furniture for 27 years. I work there part-time now so I can be full-time in my studio, creating paintings and collage. And recently I illustrated a Prairie Majesty Oracle deck, which has been beautifully received. I had a partner named Kara Simons who wrote and conceived of this beautiful deck of 48 cards that are based on prairie plants and animals, and you can choose one card or lay them out however you like. There's a guidebook that suggests how to work with the deck, and those are available at Kin in Des Moines. I'm also working on a book that is about two art shows I put together that are collage works and paintings based on the art of family tragedy and how to be amazing anyway. And that kind of looks at inherited trauma and tragedy and how we can use gratitude and showing up for ourselves, showing up for our own healing, and showing up for others to move on, to let go, to break the cycle, and to bring some forgiveness and acceptance. And that is a project I'm really excited to work on. I think that will be released in October 2022. You can find me. I'm Amy Putney Koenig on Instagram. AmyPutneyKoenig.com is my website. I do studio visits often. I'm having a studio open house October 16th and 17th. You can stop by the studio then if you're local and in Des Moines, and you can look at prints and patches and the oracle decks that we have left.
Hashtag. Oh, I love my chocolate. Hashtag treat yourself. Hashtag self-care.
Ouch! This is not right!
What the heck?
Yes, what the heck?
I mean, who the, what the... I know I shouldn't be eating carbs, but today's a cheat day. At least it's dark chocolate.
How very white of you.
Excuse me? I'm not white. I'm a Jew.
This, it's what they call a technicality.
Well, you can tell that to the alt-right. Who the heck are you, anyway?
I am the spirit of Congo. I am the spirit of the Amazon. I am the spirit of the
Amazon.
Rainforest. Well, what's left of it, anyway?
The spirit?
Well, a representative of sorts. What? You don't like spirits?
Well, I pride myself in direct communication. I mean, no offense, but, I don't know about talking to spirits. I mean, you know, like that kind of makes me feel a little crazy, you know? Like, am I imagining things? I mean, like, am I talking to myself?
Oh, hell. We're all a little bit crazy here, don't you think? That's the state of the world, the what of the what. And who doesn't talk to themselves anyway?
Well, that's true. But I prefer to talk to a person.
Well, that person, or rather, the physical manifestation of that person cannot be here today because he, she, it, they are too busy fighting for the powers of deforestation caused in part by your chocolate bar.
Seriously? My chocolate bar?
Where once I, we, us, they, it were covered in green lush forest, so green, so lush, and the chimpanzees and the elephant heart.
Now it's more common to see the skeleton of a tree.
The skeleton?
Trees burned to plant cocoa or hacked.
Ooh, ouch. Hacked?
Hacked and burned to the ground to make room for more and more cocoa farms to be harvested to make your precious chocolate bar.
Oh.
More than the 80% of my rainforest cover has been reduced since 1960 in the Ivory Coast alone.
Well, that's awful. I mean, why don't we know this?
I don't know. Maybe you don't want to know this. Maybe it benefits you not knowing about this.
Well, haven't you heard of fake news? I mean, aren't there regulations against this sort of thing?
Tell that to Mars and Nestle. They say that they are trying, but they are actually...
Yeah, but this is 72% cocoa. I mean, it is fair trade organic.
Think that's 100% pure? What percentage of the 4.5 million of cocoa farms do you think they are actually sustainability certified? Seriously? Have you heard of false advertising?
Yeah, but I got this at Whole Foods.
Whole Foods? Whole Foods? The same Whole Foods that was bought out by Amazon. No relation. That force of nature that has destroyed small independent bookstores and businesses worldwide. Screw you, Jeff Bezos, screw you!
Well, what do you expect me to do? I mean, look, the world, it's incredibly crappy right now.
Tell me about it. I am tired. My land is tired. You need to do something.
Well, look, I've been on the women's movement, and I call my senator daily, almost daily. And I'm trying to quit drinking, and I recycle. I need something. I need chocolate. And that's sustainably sourced stuff. It's expensive. But I'm trying.
That's your patch of the world, Petunia. But what about the rest of us? Let's revisit. Goodbye, green, green hills in Africa. Goodbye, gorgeous chimpanzees and elephant herds. Goodbye, my Amazon. Goodbye, my rainforest.
Goodbye.
You need to do something. A little bit of action, mobilizing.
Hashtag protect the rainforest?
Yeah, because hashtag by 2030, there may be no rainforest.
Oh, got it. Goodbye.
Burned. Hacked.
Hacked. Oh. Hashtag. Down with you climate-changing deniers and you colonizing land-poaching bastards!
Yes, and you go, girl!
Hashtag, we love our rainforest.
You go, girl! Yes.
And hashtag, even though I love your products, F you, Jeff Bezos, F you! Hashtag, we really love our rainforest. What are you doing for the planet?
Hashtag woke. Hashtag not woke enough.
Growing up in India, the sight of elephants at temples blessing children and adults by placing their trunks on people's heads, decorated elephants standing in the sun for hours during the Kerala temple festival, elephants painted with chalk designs wearing colorful coverings on their backs, the warrior elephants carrying the Raja or King, elephants carved on temple basement moldings, ivory elephants walking in a row along tusk-shaped contours were all common sights and symbols. These artistic representations don't quite address the level of harm that is done to animals that has exploded in the last several decades. In 2015, I had suddenly felt a calling to paint elephants under the title Chalk and Chains. I had been to the Dubari Elephant Camp in Coorg, India, just a few years before, and had been struck by the fact that elephants who had been crisscrossing farmlands in search of food had been captured and were being rehabilitated on account of their being too wild. When human population expands, the need for humans to encroach on wild lands becomes inevitable. We end up not being able to leave the wild alone. Elephants are then seen as pests to be rehabilitated or eradicated, not realizing the human behavior that is unable to respect the wild. Painting elephants as a meditation on this topic led me to understand that oppression is oppression, that the structure of oppression is the same whether it is humans oppressing other humans, animals, flora, or the planet itself, The structure is thus. When a person or creature or plant or planetary entity is turned into a thing, it loses its animated or living nature. Being thus objectified, it can be harmed with impunity. This axiom explains why elephants are being poached in Africa and Asia. Ivory is currency to fund terrorism or to become exotic status symbols for the upper class to show off their wealth. Elephants are no longer elephants, but tusks. This type of synecdochic representation aids and abets the oppression of the planet itself. 96 elephants are killed every day to support the ivory trade. And then there is the curious Victorian era colonial practice of taxidermy, where elephant feet are converted into stools, umbrella stands, or liquor services. It is this same type of objectification that plagues the mental health of peoples around the world. The elephant that falls in Africa is no different than George Floyd, who fell in Minneapolis, and no different than the person who is murdered by their intimate partner or adult abusing a child. Oppression is oppression. The art is the activism. The paintings embody the voices against subjugation. I pledge to paint 108 elephants to agitate against the poaching of elephants and harm done to elephants in Africa and Asia. I pledge to donate 50% of the proceeds from the sale of the paintings to Elephant Voices, an organization dedicated to the conservation of elephants.
It's not that easy being green, having to spend each day the color of the leaves, when I think it would be much nicer being red or yellow or gold or something much more colorful like that. It's not easy being green. It seems you blend in with so many other ordinary things, and people tend to pass you over because you're not standing out like flashy sparkles in the water. Stars in the sky, but green is the color of spring, and green can be big like an ocean, all important like a mountain, or tall like a tree. When green is all there is to be, it could make you wonder why. But why wonder why? Why wonder? And I'm green, and it'll do fine. It's beautiful. And I think it's what I want to be.
When will this war end? Land in this mud and smelling all these trees and these animals? You know, I have read about this, this tropical climate. Thought I might like it with the heat and all. But I can't stand it here anymore. I miss home.
I've read a little bit about tropical climates, Captain. Couldn't agree more. But maybe when the war is over, we can all go to a much cooler state like California, sexy people, beaches, you know? Maybe it's time I could finally get married.
All right, you guys obviously don't know cold weather. I'm from New York, and...
Enemy soldiers are approaching. There is a load of them. Okay, here's the plan. We have only one possible option. Play dead.
Great thinking. So when they come by, we'll just pretend we've been shot and killed. Great idea, Captain, great idea.
I mean, it'll only work if they believe you're dead.
Okay. I'll go first. I take a couple of shots off in the air, and then I fall down dead, negotiating my death. You know, I've heard about animals that play dead. They have to do it very, very good, you know, anticipating the prey. I'll do it like those animals. Now you two stay back, just in case they take me prisoner. Okay. I'm ready. Enemy soldiers are approaching. Fire! I've been shot! She will never see me again. My lovely wife, Melissa. Oh, Melissa, Melissa, I love you. I love you, Melissa.
That was great, Captain. Unbelievable. You completely fooled them. I was stunned.
Well, thanks. I took a couple of elective acting courses back at the community college. I learned all about Tennessee Williams and his driving force. Very inspirational.
Amazing performance, to say the least.
I don't know. It was decent.
What?
How do you say it?
Yeah, I mean, forgive me, Captain. There just wasn't enough backstory. Who is this Melissa? What does she mean to you? Also, could we maybe get a little more volume? I'm surprised the enemy could even hear you.
Melissa is my wife, which I mentioned as I was performing my death.
See, that's the thing. I didn't get that from your performance. It felt like the focus was too much on your death and not your loved ones. Maybe if you had a prop, like a picture of her, I would have felt more taken by your performance while also recognizing, oh, that's his wife.
Don't listen to him, because this was great.
That's fine. I always believed in a little constructive criticism. You know, I learned back in my management class back at community college that criticism is good if it's constructive. Okay, enemy soldiers are approaching.
I've got this. I've got this, Captain. Please, let me play dead this time.
Are you sure, soldier? I can do it again.
I don't know about going again, Captain. Let's recast.
It will be my honor, Captain. Hopefully I can live up to your amazing performance.
I have no doubt that you will. Go get him!
Okay.
Oh, remember, volume and backstory. Give us the reasons you feel the way you do.
Okay. Enemy soldiers are approaching.
Okay. Fire away, I'm ready! Been shot! It hurts! I see it coming. It's coming. I didn't want it to end this way.
Hey, psst. More backstory. Who are you?
I am a married woman with tons of children.
Yeah. How many children? Be specific in your character choices.
My three children that I will never see again.
Does your character have any underlying health conditions? If so, physicalize those conditions. Let us see that.
I will never see them again because I have Alzheimer's. My Alzheimer's, it hurts.
Good. Now, show us you forgot where you are. Good. Now, try to re-remember what's happening. Remember that you're dying, and then show us you die.
Enemy soldiers are approaching! Great job, soldier!
Okay, a few notes. When you fell to the ground, I almost felt like the death was too quick. Give us a moment to really register what's happening.
I just got a stab in my leg. They were completely fooled. What are you talking about?
I mean, they stabbed you because they didn't believe you. I'm just
what
trying to-
What the hell are you talking about?
Knock it off! Knock it off, you two! That's no way for a team to act. I learned in my management class that where there is some conflict, there is always a resolution.
I agree. The solution is much more character and much more volume. Guys, how are we supposed to convince the enemy we're in pain if they can't even hear us?
Well, soldier, perhaps you would like to show us how it's done. Playing dead, that is. I think there's another group of soldiers approaching. Prove to them that you're dead, and then perhaps we can get back to base camp.
You know, gladly. I'd love to. Mm-hmm. Just give me a few shots, and I'll take the stage. Ha! 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 Onion, onion, onion. How much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck-
Get to it, soldier!
Okay. I'm ready now. Ah! Oh, I've been shot. Not once, not twice, but four times.
It was three shots, soldier.
Well, make it four, damn it. This needs to be real. As I said, I was shot four times. Ah. 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 Oh. I'll never see her again. My wife. My little Dorothy. Oh, it hurts. Oh, and I have this terrible back condition. Also, my leg just broke. Oh, my arm, it's also broken. Oh God, look at my arm break. Well, I'll use my other arm one last time for a good old cigarette. I love cigarettes. You know, back when I was a kid, I always used to smoke to impress my teacher, Miss Susie. Oh, I guess my other arm feels so much better now. I can use it. the cigarette. I also have asthma. Oh no, I'm dead. Not because of the cigarette, but because of my 5 gunshot wounds.
There was 4.
Oh, I also have Alzheimer's and I can't seem to remember how many times. Okay, I remember now. It was 5. 5 shots. 6! Okay, I was just shot again. I'm dying now because I was shot 6. Okay, enough already. I get it.
Great job, soldier. Let's get out of here.
Aku ai
where the mind is without fear and the head is held high. Where knowledge is free. Where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Where words come out from the depth of truth. Where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection. Where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. Where the mind is led forward by thee into ever widening thought and action. Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. No peace in the world without peace in the nation. No peace in the nation without peace in the village. No peace in the village without peace in the family. No peace in the family without peace in the heart. And I wish you peace in the heart. I wish you peace in the heart. I wish you peace in the heart.